It's a fairly simple procedure, one that makes most people squirm.
It's not necessarily so routine as we're taught it is.
What Tana and Brent McWillis didn't realize is that it could kill their son Riley. A BC coroner's report shows one-month-old Riley McWillis suffered a severe hemorrhage after being circumcised.
I honestly didn't realize that it's honestly only about an ounce worth of blood that they can lose. I mean, that's not very much blood. And if you weren't informed that way, how would you know?
Tana and Brent were given instructions to care for Riley after the circumcision, but even the coroner indicates those instructions could have been better. They were told a fair bit of blood was normal. By morning, Riley was in shock. He was flown to Vancouver by air ambulance, where he died. The coroner rules the death accidental and describes medical treatment as appropriate and timely. The coroner does not make recommendations for preventing further deaths. Riley's parents are insulted. They say it implies they neglected Riley. They say they had no way of knowing their baby boy was bleeding to death.
I think that we need to be better informed. And I think that that information given to every single parent that wants to leave the hospital is going to make it so that my child didn't die in vain.
Only decades ago, about half of all Canadian boys were circumcised. Now, less than 20%. Back in Penticton, the hospital has a new procedure for circumcisions, a more descriptive pamphlet, and a follow-up phone call from a nurse.
And the nurse goes through with the parents a list of questions that they ask the parents about swelling, about diapers, about bleeding.
But that's just one hospital. Riley's parents were hoping for changes across Canada. They say this coroner's report won't make a difference. They hope their story will. Bonnie Allen, CBC News, Columbia.